आपला देश सध्या मोठ्या आव्हानांना सामोरा जात आहे. कोरोना काळात देशाच्या उत्तरेकडील आणि उत्तरेकडील पश्चिम भागातील घडामोडींमध्ये वाढ झाली आहे. आपले सीमेवरील सैन्य दल त्याला सामोरे जाण्यासाठी खंबीरपणे सज्ज आहे. परंतु युद्ध हे फक्त दोन सैन्यांमधील नसून दोन देशांमधील तणावामुळे निर्माण झालेले असते हे समजून घ्यायला हवे असं मत लष्कर प्रमुख जनरल मनोज नरवणे यांनी व्यक्त केले.
भारतीय चित्रपट आणि दूरचित्रवाणी संस्थेतील दूरचित्रवाणी विभागाच्या सुवर्ण महोत्सवानिमित्त विभागाच्या इमारतीला पु ल देशपांडे यांचे नाव देण्यात आले. तसेच विभागातील दोन स्टुडिओंना पी कुमार वासुदेव आणि प्राध्यापक वसंत मुळे यांचे नाव देण्यात आले आहे. यानिमित्त आयोजित कार्यक्रम नरवणे यांच्या उपस्थितीत झाला. यावेळी ज्येष्ठ दिग्दर्शिका सई परांजपे, ज्येष्ठ दिग्दर्शक डॉक्टर जब्बार पटेल, संस्थेचे संचालक भूपेंद्र कैथोला आदी मान्यवर उपस्थित होते. नरवणे म्हणाले, FTII हे ऑडिओ आणि व्हिज्युअल माध्यमातील सर्वोत्कृष्टतेचे केंद्र आहे. कला जीवन अधोरेखित करते तर समाजाचे प्रतिबिंब चित्रपटातून उमटते. अनेक संवेदनशील विषय भारतीय चित्रपटातून आजवर मांडण्यात आले आहेत. चित्रपट आणि TV मालिकांमधून प्रबोधन जागृतीचे काम होते. यावेळी नरवणे यांनी FTII आणि पुण्यातील आठवणींना उजाळा दिला. कैथोला म्हणाले, FTII हे चित्रपट आणि दूरचित्रवाणी IIT आहे. संस्थेत चित्रपटाकडे केवळ मनोरंजन म्हणून पाहिले जात नाही तर चित्रपटाला एक कला आणि कौशल्य म्हणून पाहिले जाते. पु ल देशपांडे यांचे FTII वेगळेच नाते होते. त्यांचे अनेक रेकॉर्डिंग संस्थेत झाली आहेत. संस्थेत येऊन शिक्षण घेऊ न शकणाऱ्या विद्यार्थ्यांना संस्थेने पुण्याबाहेर जाऊन शिक्षण द्यायला सुरुवात केली आहे. डॉक्टर पटेल यांनी पु ल देशपांडे यांच्यासह FTII जुन्या आठवणींना यावेळी उजाळा दिला.
विजिट टू पुणे इज ऑलवेज नॉस्टैल्जिक and it takes me down memory lane. मेरे दादाजी का घर प्रभात रोड पर था और मेरे नाना जी का करवे रोड पर. और जब हम छुट्टियों के लिए गर्मी के छुट्टियों में आते थे तो हमेशा एक घर से दूसरे घर आना जाना होता था और वो भी पैदल. शायद तभी मुझे आर्मी में पैदल सेना में भेजा. लेकिन आते जाते हमेशा FTII के सामने से गुजरना पड़ता था. लेकिन मेरा FTII के साथ इतना ही कनेक्शन है. FTII के अंदर मैं पहली बार आया हूं. सो टुडे दैट विश ऑफ एंटरिंग द FTII हैज ऑल्सो बीन फुलफिल्ड. आई फील इमेंसली प्राउड सीइंग दिस स्प्रॉलिंग FTII कैंपस एंड द हिस्टोरिक प्रभात स्टूडियोज. The FTI has come a long way since the establishment of the Prabhat Film Company way back in 1963. A stellar and pioneering film company of its time, it produced several important and iconic films. The legacy of this studio, once the biggest in Asia, lives on through the FTII. My compliments and congratulations to the faculty members, staff and alumni for 60 years of unparalleled contribution to the film and television industry of India. It is also a special occasion for the Institute's TV wing for completing 50 years of their establishment. Their golden jubilee also coincides with another landmark occasion, the victory of India over Pakistan in the 1971 war and the liberation of Bangladesh. This year, being observed as the Swarnim Vijay Varsh by the armed forces all across the country. I also wish to congratulate the FTI for dedicating the impressive TV building to the memory of Sri Purushottam Lakshman Deshpande, the proud recipient of the Padma Shri in 1966 and the Padma Bhushan in 1990, and fondly remembered as Pula. He remains an iconic figure of our times. He wore many hats with equal ease and finesse: playwright, music director, actor, translator, orator, academic, and many others. A media article I recently chanced upon aptly describes his larger-than-life persona, and I quote, "Pu ll made Marathis laugh at their foibles and follies, helping them retain their faith in humanism, pluralism, and democratic values," unquote. These values are intrinsic to a national character, and he epitomized these through his works. To be able to stand back and laugh at yourself is a great quality very few possess, a mark of humility and greatness in equal measure. This initiative of the FTII of honoring the legacy of Pola Deshpande is indeed praiseworthy. It is yet another acknowledgement of his unparalleled contribution to Marathi literature. This building dedicated to him will continue to inspire those who walk through the portals of FTII to rise above the ordinary and leave their footprints in the sands of time. The mention of his characters will always bring a smile to our faces and tickle the funny bone within. Such is his legacy. It also gives me great pleasure to dedicate the two renovated 3B studios to the memory of Mr. V.J. Mule and Mr. P. Kumar Vasudev, two stalwarts of the FTII. Mr. Mule was in fact involved with Doordarshan from the early days when we were still experimenting with TV transmission. There are many firsts to his credit, as was mentioned earlier, and in the film also, from the first outdoor live telecast of the Republic Day Parade to the color telecast of the 1982 Asian Games in Delhi. It is a reflection of the central role he played to the growth of Indian television during those formative years. Mr. Vasudev is another contemporary of that golden generation, an alumni of the FTII. His contribution to Doordarshan and to Indian television is well acknowledged. He will always, however, be remembered and synonymous with India's first soap opera, Hum Log. He mesmerized audiences across the country as they readily identified with each of the characters. It was not just pure entertainment. Hum Log was also about addressing social issues and reinforcing our family values. Both Mr. Mule and Mr. Vasudev shall forever be remembered for their pioneering work in shaping the Indian TV industry during this initial phase. The ceremony today is indeed a fitting tribute to their unmatched contribution. The FTII is recognized as a center of excellence in the audiovisual media. Its contribution to Indian society and to our culture through its industrial alumni, both in India and overseas, is well acknowledged. The role of mainstream cinema in reinforcing our core values, preserving our diverse culture, and galvanizing the nation in times of crisis cannot be overemphasized. Art imitates life. Films are a reflection of our society. At the same time, they leave a deep imprint and even shake us up from our indifference and apathy to many important issues. It takes courage and self-belief to talk about sensitive subjects like sexual violence, honor killings, dowry, drug abuse, reservations, religious intolerance, and many more such topical issues. War movies have always had an enduring impact on people of all ages, especially our youth. These films have immortalized our soldiers in the heart of every Indian. We have grown up watching these films, which have captured the valor and travails of our armed forces. They still serve to reinforce the spirit of supreme sacrifice of our soldiers in the nation's conscience. A large number of TV serials too have taken the life and challenges of the frontline to every home, creating better awareness amongst our society while firing up the youth to join the armed forces. The interaction and outreach by popular actors in difficult areas has further reinforced this bond between the military and our society. And I would like to take this opportunity to gratefully acknowledge the role of the entertainment industry in making this possible. On a lighter note, I have always found the stereotyping of the Indian officer in films both amusing and intriguing. The beautiful heroine's father is always a khadus colonel wearing a silk dressing gown with a whiskey in one hand and a shotgun in the other. Really intrigues me. But while creative license is understood, I believe that stereotyping of communities and characters is best avoided, lest we start believing in it. While all this is perhaps well known, I must also acknowledge the FTI's own efforts in recent years to reach out to the youth of the Union Territory of JNK. Your workshops on screenwriting, acting and filmmaking were received with great enthusiasm in the Valley. The personal initiative of the director, Mr. Bhupender Kenthola, was the key to the successful initiative. The pandemic has perhaps severed this link. However, such initiatives to empower the youth are indeed the need of the hour. And as the director mentioned, the Indian Army is again ready to take on the role of facilitator to restart this initiative. The nation is passing through a challenging period. The exigencies on our active and unsettled borders, both on the west and the north, have only increased in the times of the pandemic. The Indian Army, your army, has stood tall and strong in the face of these challenges. However, I have always maintained that wars are not fought between armies, wars are waged between nations, and it requires a whole of nation effort. While hard power in our context will always be relevant, equally important is the leveraging of our soft power.